Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'da habati fillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, wa ma khalaqtu al-jinna wal insa illa liya'budun. I have not created mankind in the jinn except for the purpose of worshipping me. So we know that our divine purpose of why we were created is Tawheed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in an authentic hadith, a hadith of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, in which he sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked about ihsan. He was asked about what is the concept of ihsan, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "In ta'budu Allaha ka'annaka yarak, fa in lam tarahu fa innahu yarak. In ta'budu Allaha ka'annaka tarahu fa in lam yakun tarahu fa innahu yarak." The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you see him, and because you cannot see him, know that he sees you." So we have to know that ubudiyatillah, you know, the subservience of us as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation, that we need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is our call. That's why we call to Tawheed, our da'wah to Tawheed. That doesn't mean that doesn't include all the other ways we reform ourselves. But Tawheed is the asas. Tawheed is the asas of Islam. And it is what, it's the foundation of Islam. And everything is done as an act of worship to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we rectify the community by worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. That doesn't mean we don't have social programs. It doesn't mean we don't feed the poor and stuff. No, all those are acts of ibadah, as long as our intention is to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to worship Him, tabarak wa ta'ala, alone. And this is how we reform ourselves and reform the community and fulfill our divine purpose. Imam al-Tabari, rahimahullah ta'ala, he cites a narration of Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu in his tafsir. And he said about this verse that mankind and jinn were created to worship Allah alone. He says that Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, "Mankind and jinn were created to worship Allah alone with complete subservience to his commands." So by being subservient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commands, meaning everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded that we strive our best to do and fulfill, then that is worship. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to command the good and forbid the evil. So that means commanding the good and forbidding the evil, if our intention is correct, will be to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala commands us to be obedient and obey and be righteous towards our parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ بِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And your Lord has ordered you to worship Him and Him alone, and to be kind or righteous towards one's parents. So that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding you to worship Him and Him alone. And part of that worshiping Him and Him alone, part of that which is an act of worship, is actually being obedient to one's parents and serving one's parents. So that shows us that all of those things make up ibadah and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that all falls under Tawheed. That's why Tawheed is the asas. And Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah ta'ala, he has a very famous book entitled Fiqh al-Akbar. Fiqh al-Akbar. The greater fiqh, if you will. And Fiqh al-Akbar, this refers to things of i'tiqad, of creed. You know, of what we believe. Tawheed, belief in the malaika, belief in the pillars of the iman, and tu'mina billahi wa malaikati wa kutubihi wa rasulihi wa al-yawm al-akhir, tu'mina bi qadri khayrihi wa shar, and to believe in the divine decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his books and his angels, alayhim, and his messengers, alayhim afdal salatu wa salam. All of those things are creed. And then they refer to the minor fiqh, which is jurisprudence, and how our fiqh al-mu'amalat, as the fiqh al-askar. Why? As the minor fiqh? Because fiqh al-askar will not be accepted without fiqh al-akbar. The greater fiqh is Tawheed and worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your creed, your aqidah. Because without correct aqidah, especially if your aqidah is, you know, deviant to the extent of disbelief, we're not talking about just being from Ahl Bid'ah. That doesn't mean you, if someone from Ahl Bid'ah, for example, that doesn't mean their deeds are not accepted. But it means the deeds in which they do, in which there's bid'ah, is rejected. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, "Kullu bid'atin dalala," or he ﷺ said, "Min ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fa rad." Whoever innovates in this affair of ours will have it rejected. So that lets us know that the act of bid'ah that you do is rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. And so, you know, it's very important that we rectify and concern ourselves with the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala by His divine names and attributes to accept our good and forgive our evil, and bless us with ikhlas, with thabat, and bless us to meet Him on khair wa sunnah, wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.